That's a good fighter. So I don't know who the next generation of star can be. I don't know if it's going to be one guy, though. You know, it's like when Alexander the Great died in Greece, and then the kingdom got split into three. You know what I mean? It wasn't one king. It was, like, three. You know what I mean? It might not be, like, one king that, like, is, like, the man in boxing and, like, sells up all the pay-per-views and does all the things, like, we've had of late. Maybe it might be, like, it might get spread out a little more, and you'd have, like, a lot of big names and a lot of, like, pretty big names. Not huge, like, now, but, like, pretty big names, but they have so much exposure that, you know, it keeps the flow going as far as the following of the sport. So, you know, it could be that. So we'll see. I mean, again, this is just speculation on my part, but I'm not worried about boxing. I think it's going to be all right. I think there's a lot of avenues.
You need that pay-per-view star, though.
I don't think you'll have one pay-per-view star. I think matchups will be pay-per-view matchups. That's what I'm saying. I think there'll be enough good fighters around where it won't be one pay-per-view star particularly. But, like, certain matchups will be so big because, you know, people will start to get to know these fighters from network television that certain matchups will be like, oh, that's the one. You know, let's put that one on pay-per-view. And maybe that same guy the next time might not be on pay-per-view. You know what I mean? Or you build a pay-per-view star that way where you get enough of those big matches, the guy keeps winning, and you build one pay-per-view star. But it depends. But I think you'll have more matchups that are pay-per-view than a single star, and then maybe you can develop that single star from there if somebody comes out from the mess.
Yeah. Paulie, were you here for the Manny press conference?
No, I just got here now. I didn't even realize the press conference was here. I went to return my tuxedo to Showtime, and I was like, what's going on in here? And then the press conference is going on. So I walked in.
He said that he hurt his shoulder 2 weeks ago, and in the third round it really bothered him.
Yeah.
And then he said that he felt that he won the fight because he hurt Floyd 3 or 4 times in a fight. Yeah. Like, he believed that he won. What do you think? I mean, as a fighter...
Did anybody ask him how to spell Soul Loser after that? Oh, no. Nobody asked. Damn, that's a question you forgot to ask. That's the thing. So I would heard that. I would ask him how to spell Soul Loser. Here's the thing with going into a fight with an injury. Because you're speaking to somebody that went into a lot of fights with injuries, okay? Early in my career, I was going into fights with legitimately broken hands, legitimately. You know what you do when you go into fights with injuries? You don't talk all that shit because you know you're up against your back is to the wall already. So you try to not deaden the promotion. You don't try to look scared. You try to put your poker face on. But you don't say things like Freddie Roach is saying where he's hitting harder than he's ever hit before. Or like Manny said, my killer instinct is back. You don't say those things when you know you're going into the fight with an injury. So that's how you know he's full of shit, because I've gone into fights with injuries, and what you do is you put your best poker face on, you come in, you tell everybody you're ready, but you don't overdo it with making statements that are gonna give people a certain expectancy of your performance, because you know you have that injury. Again, speaking of somebody that's had an injury, so I know exactly how you go into fights with an injury and the mentality you have. What they were saying this week shows he had no injury. They're full of shit.
Hey, Paulie, with the loss though, who would you like to see Manny fight next?
Well, Manny could fight a lot of guys. I think, 140 pounds, top rank, some good fighters. You know, Terrence Crawford, Jesse Vargas.
About Matisse?
Matisse would be dynamite, yeah. I mean, I don't know if you want to... I think Manny could use a little, not a softball. I won't say a softball, but, you know, a comeback win, you know, against a pretty good fighter, but not, maybe one of those guys, and then maybe move into one of those guys.
What about Amir Khan down the road?
Amir Khan is a threat for both Floyd and Manny.
How about Paulie Malignaggi for Manny Pacquiao?
Let's do it.
Let's do it?
Yeah, let's do it. We'll do it right now.
All right,
we gotta sign up to random drug testing.
Tell the fans where to follow you.
At Paul Malignaggi on Twitter, at Malignaggi on Instagram. Check out my podcast, Paul Malignaggi, From Brooklyn to the World. And stop the hate. You know how much hate I'm getting on Twitter? I told everybody I'd take excuses tonight. And instead, everybody's hating again. Enough with the hate. Guys, you were wrong. That's it. Listen to me. I'll teach you about boxing.
From one person who's hated to the number one hated guy in boxing, FaceTheReport.com and Ballistic Back reporting. I'm the hated king.
What's up, hey, are you done?
Yeah.